This week from Hollywood, we're taking you to the Here Comes the Boom premiere with Henry Winkler, Kevin James, Selma Hayek, and Baz Rutten.
He made 10 grand for that fight? He lost.
Hey, if he won, it would have been 50.
To the Paul Weller concert with former Soprano star Jamie Lynn Sigler. Plus, we shine the spotlight on actor-director Ben Affleck to find out what makes the talented man tick.
This is what I do, and I've never left anyone behind.
Then, we take you out to dinner with John Mayer and Katy Perry on his birthday and show you Kristen Stewart's new pad. All these updates and more coming up. But first, let's take a look at the red carpet. Here Comes the Boom made its New York City premiere at Lowe's Theaters Lincoln Cinemas in Manhattan.
Excuse me?
The Fonz Henry Winkler was there walking the red carpet alongside Baz Rutten. Henry looked dapper in his coat and scarf and told us that he is living the phrase,
"Be very careful what you wish for." This opens October 12th.
Thank you.
1 month later, I open in a brand new romantic comedy on Broadway called The Performers. Oh my God.
You want to be a fighter?
Wearing a tie and jacket, Baz told us that Kevin James was a fighter in the film, and he was extremely pleased with the outcome.
He's a scrapper. He's always been. But Kevin is the black and white guy. You know, it's the same as any other fighter or like myself. There's no gray areas. When he says, "I'm going to do something," he went all the way. I mean, he lost a tremendous amount of weight. He started training 14 months out before we start shooting the movie. He trained like a mixed martial arts, sparred with all the pros. He trained 2-3 times a day. It was greens, vegetables. You know, we were eating pizzas and great stuff on the set, and he had to do these crazy shakes. He hated it, but you know, he did it, and he looks phenomenal. You'll be amazed once you see it.
Did he take any real hits?
Oh yeah, and you will see those also.
Dreams are about to come true.
That go in?
King of Queens actor Kevin James said he lost all of the weight he carried into the pre-production phase of Here Comes the Boom, but has since gained most of it back. His jovial charm was captivating on the red carpet as he engaged reporters.
It's drinking the greens. It was working out 2-3 times a day, sparring with these guys, and it was grueling. But I'm telling you, I'm excited because I've got it documented. It's good.
Selma Hayek stood close to Kevin on the red carpet, but managed to break away to steal some time with us. She called Kevin generous, talented, and fun.
Oh, I love him. We've done 3 movies by now. And we also did a sketch with Jimmy Kimmel a while ago. It was like a little thing. He's generous and talented, so talented and fun. And we really like improvising together, you know? Improvising is a tricky thing.
Yeah.
You have to have a good partner to do it with, and he's the best.
You dislocated your shoulder.
You gotta help me.
You ready? I always wanted to try this.
Try this? What do you mean try? You never done this?
Don't!
Former Soprano star Jamie Lynn Sigler attended the Paul Weller concert at the 10th anniversary of John Varvatos in L.A. She wore an off-the-shoulder dress with her hair tied back and chewed gum while posing for photos with fans and photographers. Eric Balfour was also in attendance. He posed alone with his hair slicked back in a ponytail. The man of the hour, Paul Weller, took the stage with his band during the event. The A-list crowd shimmied with the best of them during his scheduled appearance. Anthony Anderson signed autographs for fans on his way out of the party. Waving the peace sign and watching out for oncoming traffic, Anthony chatted for a few minutes before walking across the street to his destination.
Hey, how you doing?
We caught up with recently engaged beauty queen Sofia Vergara in Hollywood, where she was shooting a new scene for Modern Family. The buxom actress was filming on the street in LA opposite Ed O'Neill. The co-stars appeared focused and friendly, despite the flock of onlookers surrounding their cameras. Sophia was sporting a faux baby bump underneath a green dress. As far as we know, the pregnancy is completely fictional. Everyone's favorite red-eyed vampire, Kristen Stewart, has purchased a $2.2 million home less than 2 miles from her beau Robert Pattinson's house, a home they once shared together. Robert and Kristen were spotted enjoying some PDA at her new home near Los Feliz's Laughlin Park. The two were spotted kissing by her pool. could they really be back on again? Or is it just a creative ploy to promote the new Twilight Breaking Dawn Part 2 franchise? Robert is currently in Australia promoting Twilight, while Kristen made the rounds in Japan signing autographs with fans. Looks like they're back on again. Romantic crooner John Mayer sparked some fireworks while celebrating his 35th birthday with girlfriend Katy Perry. The low-key couple enjoyed dinner at New York City Eatery, burgers, oysters, and cocktails before heading over to the Box nightclub. John wore a handsome bow tie, and Katy let her dark long locks down for the occasion. Just like any doting mom, Katy Holmes walked her daughter Siri to school in New York City. Unlike other regular moms, though, there were cameras following her, and she appeared none too happy. Both mother and daughter held on to one another tightly while walking in the crisp fall air, a far cry from the LA lifestyle they left behind following Katy's quickie divorce from Tom Cruise. We checked in with Fergie at The Grove in LA, where she was chatting up a young fan. The Black Eyed Peas singer laughed at us when we asked her if she was ready to start a family of her own. Fergie was in town promoting Voli Light Vodka.
Thank you.
What happened?
Six of the hostages went out a back exit.
Where are they? The Canadian ambassador's house.
You got Revolutionary Guards going door to door. These people die. They die badly.
I got an idea.
They're a Canadian film crew for a science fiction movie.
I fly into Tehran. We all fly out together as a film crew.
This week, we shine the spotlight on Oscar winner Ben Affleck. He played a lovable student in Good Will Hunting, a superb hero in Armageddon, and replicated his heroic efforts in Pearl Harbor. The actor is married to actress Jennifer Garner. Ben's latest role is as actor-director in the hit blockbuster Argo. We caught up with him to chat about his latest project and his penchant for directing.
When you're directing an actor like Bryan Cranston, it doesn't take much because, you know, I don't think I ever told him anything or directed him in any specific ways. I mean, I would keep going and I knew that he would change and kind of different things would happen, but it was more like fun, like just getting to work with a really good actor that you liked and respected. And so a lot of the process I try to let be like that, you know, more easygoing and free-flowing, because I think that relaxation is the main key to success.
Argo, science fantasy adventure.
Moonscape, Mars, desert.
You need an exotic location to shoot.
You need a producer.
If I'm doing a fake movie, it's going to be a fake hit.
This is really what I love. I love doing this. I love to be on sets and create stuff and make something interesting happen artistically and creatively and express myself in this way.
The Argo crew was given special access to film by the CIA so that the movie would look realistic.
It was incredible. It wasn't me. We kind of rode the reputation of Tony Mendez. And, you know, he's won the Intelligence Star. He's an important guy there. He's somebody, I think they wanted his story to be told in some ways because it spoke to the larger story of all the people who work there, who don't get there. To have their names heard, but who do exceptional things, or even maybe don't crash into windows and have shootouts with bad guys, but just, you know, travel overseas and their marriage suffers, or the relationship with their kids suffers, or, you know, whatever it may be.
Actions of Iran have shocked the civilized world.
I got the script sent to me by Warner Brothers, and I said, this is incredible. And they, you know, who is this, or whatever. They said, Grant and George are producing it. So then I called them and said, guys, I want to do this movie. You're like, what's it going to take? What do I have to do? Here's my take. Here's how I would do it. Here's how I would shoot it. Here's the, you know, kind of manic. I think they were just like, all right, I calm down, you know. But they were really cool and didn't take long. And next thing you know, we were off and going.
You really believe your little story is going to make a difference when there's a gun to our heads?
I think my little story is the only thing between you and a gun to your head.
Everyone's favorite sleepless in Seattle dad, Tom Hanks, slipped the F-bomb on Good Morning America while promoting his new film, Cloud Atlas. The incident occurred when host Elizabeth Vargas asked Tom to speak in his character's accent. As we now all know, Tom's character has one killer tongue. Music sensation Bruno Mars hosted Saturday Night Live, and it was the show's highest ratings feat since Lindsay Lohan's controversial appearance on March 3rd. The show featured popular parodies of the second presidential debate and was a hit with viewers. The Marvel Disney Iron Man empire is expanding with Iron Man 3. The sneak peek trailer has gone public, and the hype is just now beginning. The film stars Robert Downey Jr., Gwyneth Paltrow, Ben Kingsley, and Guy Pearce.
It's not a journey. Every journey ends, but we go on.
Brad Pitt stars in a brand new Chanel No. 5 fragrance commercial, and it appears to be an ode to his flame, Angelina Jolie. With the tagline, "Wherever I go, there you are," and images of a tall, dark-haired maven throughout, it goes without saying that Brad appears to have penned a love letter of sorts to his Wonder Woman and mother of their six children.
Number 5. Inevitable.
Alex Cross.
Got ourselves a Four Roses. Hey, Alex.
You're gonna want to prepare yourself for this one. Woman was tortured to death.
This week's Hollywood box office countdown has Halloween on the brain with a spooky new addition and a couple of old favorites. First, in spot number 5, Alex Cross, starring Tyler Perry, Matthew Fox, and Rachel Nichols. Alex Cross pocketed $11.8 million this weekend.
Somebody to pay wants the world to suffer.
Listen to me carefully, Kim.
Your mother is going to be taken. And people are going to come for you, too.
What are you going to do?
What I do best.
After two consecutive weeks at number 1 on our Hollywood box office countdown, Taken 2 has moved to spot number 4 this week. Taken 2 earned $13.4 million and stars Liam Neeson, Famke Janssen, and Maggie Grace.
I love this guy!
In spot number 3 from spot number 4 last week, Hotel Transylvania, starring Adam Sandler, Selena Gomez, Andy Samberg, Kevin James, Fran Drescher, Molly Shannon, and CeeLo Green. Hotel Transylvania brought in box office gold with $13.5 million. In spot number 2 for the second time on our countdown with $16.6 million, the Ben Affleck-directed film Argo, starring Affleck, John Goodman, and Bryan Cranston.
I need you to help me make a fake movie.
So you want to come to Hollywood and act like a big shot without actually doing anything?
Yeah.
You'll fit right in.
Yeah, can you see him?
What the hell?
He's so creepy.
What is he doing?
Freaky, right?
Yeah. What's going on?
The moment you've all been waiting for. Paranormal Activity 4 is the number 1 film on our countdown this week with an impressive $30.2 million in box office sales. This freaky film stars Katie Featherston, Catherine Newton, and Sprague Graydon. Hollywood birthdays this week have our celebrities turning anywhere from 25 to 87. Here's our list of not-to-miss famous birthdays. Bam! Celebrity chef Emeril Lagasse turned 53. Laverne and Shirley star Penny Marshall turned 70. Three's Company star Suzanne Somers turned 66. Murder, She Wrote icon Angela Lansbury turned 87. High School Musical alum Zac Efron turned 25. Kim Kardashian turned 32. And Tom Petty is a refugee at 62. Be sure to tune in next week for more glitz, glamour, and news from the Hollywood News Feed.